Infinity Radio.
Yo, yo. What up, West Texas? You're listening to Infinity Radio, sponsored by Wireless for You and Hip Hop Trends. I'm gonna be your host, your boy Halfbreed. And before I get started, I want to give a big shout out to everybody on Facebook who got out there on the post and watched the video last week. Awesome. I got a lot of views, a lot of response. People were digging it. And personally, I'd like to thank everybody who hit the share on it. You know, my phone got me a little alert every single time someone shared that thing. And I appreciate each and every one of y'all every single time y'all did it. But we got us a great show tonight. Got us some badass guests. A lot of topics to go over. So if you're listening, kick your feet up, peep game, and let's get on with these introductions. What up, Spree?
Man, what's good? It's your boy DJ Spree in the building.
What's up, man? How was your week? How was work?
Shit, work, bro. Fuck that shit, bro. Fuck that place to the max, man. Middle fingers up to that place, man.
Okay. Yeah?
For reals, man. Got me going through some shit.
Fuck them.
Fuck that shit.
But check it out, y'all. Spree's going to play the background this week. You know what I'm saying? He'll chime in throughout the episode, giving, you know, his perspective from a DJ on it. But going on to my other guests, you know what I'm saying? Let's start off with the one, the only, one and only.
What's up?
Oh no.
One and only, aka Oh No, aka Oh No Naki. Most often around, represent Hell's Wind. OD to Bean Town in this bitch.
Shout out to R1.
R1. Mm-hmm. What's up, Amen?
Yep.
So what's up, man? Congratulations, by the way.
I appreciate it, brother.
Yeah.
Got a new little baby.
Got a baby. What'd you have?
Little girl.
Little girl. Yeah. What'd you name her?
Hazy Daisy.
Hazy Daisy, huh?
Yeah, you know, it's nice. Kind of represents my life.
Hell yeah. Where did it all come from? Just,
you know. Just...
Little Daisy.
Purple haze.
Yeah.
Smoking them flowers. I don't know. I won't be doing that shit no more, though.
Shout out to my P.O.
Yeah.
Shout out to the P.O. Shout out to the state of Texas.
Yeah. Getting my money.
All right. Hey, that was a crazy day for you, right? I read, you know, that it wasn't just a birth that day.
Yeah, it was crazy, man. The day my little girl was born, you know, 5 hours before that, my dad died. You know,
wow.
Been dealing with some, you know, drinking issues.
So
kind of tore him up, but, you know.
Yeah, I feel that. I feel that. My father passed away. I went through some things for a good minute.
I remember that. But I lost one and got one. So.
Right. His energy's circle of flowing. Life.
Yeah, that's what's up.
Yeah,
it's a circle of life.
Hey, what's the word on I heard a rumor that you was retired from battling.
Yeah, man, I retired the other day. What? Oh, battling? I thought you were talking about, because I posted some shit. I retired from rap the other day, and like 5 minutes later, I came back.
Oh.
And like 10 minutes later, I took another break.
He's doing that.
Jay-Z. Yeah,
yeah. No, I retired from battle rap, man. That shit's just not good for me, because it's not conducive to my positive lifestyle I'm trying to lead, man, you know?
Yeah.
I'm tired of walking around thinking of hateful shit to say all the time to somebody.
Right.
Battling my mom, battling my kid, battling my girl, you know? Just pretty much just yelling at everybody all the time, because I'm in beast mode, so,
yeah.
You know, I give it up. I had to hang up my mic on that shit.
Word, well, shit,
I... There ain't no money in it anyway.
Yeah, but hey, it's money. You know?
Shout out, I've been trying to get money at one point in time.
Show me where the money at, I'll be there quick.
Shout out to DDP, I love you.
Alrighty, we're going to come back to Ono here in a little bit, get us more opinions on him on more things here in a second. Moving on, we got Philip Mendoza, a.k.a. Young Gunna, a.k.a. Cashmere the Prince.
Hell yeah, we in this motherfucker. Shout out to Half Breed, man.
What's up, man?
For putting us all together, man. It's mad dope, man.
It's nice, right?
Ever since day one, you always show love to me, man. I respect that shit, you know what I'm saying? A lot of cats out here don't be really showing that shit. It takes a hell of a man to do that, you feel me?
Hell yeah.
Put this all together and shit.
Trying to put on, man. We got to support. We got to come up with
something. West Texas in the building, man. You know what I'm saying?
Hey, all the Texas, though.
You know what I'm saying? Texas, baby. We all in this motherfucker together. You know what I'm saying? We put this shit together, and we outshining all these motherfuckers out here. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
But we got to be smart with it. We got to be smart with it. You know? These other cats hating on the motherfucker. Just put it all together.
Yeah,
right.
Salute, man.
I hear you. I feel you on that. So, man, I've been when I first saw your videos coming out, your YouTube is really popping. Your views are crazy through the roof,
man.
In comparison to everybody else out here.
Hey, man, my first video I ever did, Make That Ass Clap, was like 30,000 views, homie.
He said 30,000.
Yeah, that's like Make That Ass Clap, but you know what I'm saying? But one thing we all know is sex sells.
Right.
Just check it out, because I come through harder than a motherfucker on my next video. I'm a killer, spitting that, you know what I'm saying? Punchline, get like 5,000 views. You feel what I'm saying?
Yeah.
When you put some of that, you know what I'm saying? Make some girls ass class. You put some ass cheeks up in your video. You gonna get some kind of views. You feel what I'm saying?
But shout out to the respectable women.
Respectable women. I love y'all.
Clap that asshole.
Any other models? Any other unrespectable women? You can meet me after the show, and I'll take you back. You know what I'm saying? I got a pocket full of jimmies. My bad. We're keeping this a PG show, right?
Nah, fuck that.
You know what I'm saying? I'm bringing something new to this shit. You know, I know we got it. My brother know Big Park in this motherfucking building. Uh-huh. And my home right Uno on a positive note.
Yeah.
My bad. I'm bringing something negative. I'm sorry. That's that Southside Odessa in me, though.
Man, that's Odessa.
Salute to the Southside, though. Y'all made me. You know
we
what
like
I'm saying?
To have fun, though. You know
I ain't trying to be on no other note. You know what I'm saying? This is how the hood raised me. Made me, so I'm going to stick with it. You feel me?
Yeah. That's what's up. All right, moving on to the next guest here. This guy is an OD, OG, a veteran, been in the game, doing it, been rapping just about as long as me since back in the gap. Y'all know him from the shack. Y'all know him from the trunk. 432, I give y'all Big Perk.
What's good, 432, what it is. We in the building. We representing, man. It's a lot of love in the building, man. Hey, don't ever, ever sleep on the west side of Texas, baby. We coming and we going for you all the way, full throttle. Let's go.
Man, how you been, Perk?
Man, I've been good, man. God has been really blessing my life, man. Every angle of my life has been blessed. And I just want to give a shout out to everybody like yourself, man. People that have been in the game for such a long time, man. I appreciate the different people right here that we have on this panel, man. I'm talking about artists coming together and doing things. Whether it's, you know, for me, I like to be a little bit more positive on everything because, you know, I let negativity control my life. So I seen I was in a downward spiral. But praise be to God that I changed my life, and I'm trying to inspire younger kids to want to do something with their life instead of throw it away, because we always have that one choice, and that one choice can dictate your life, whether it's good or bad. You know what I'm saying? So that's what I'm doing. And
that's real.
I just want to say that DJ Spree and also Habry, man, you guys don't understand how important little things like this. It may seem little to some people, but this is huge to us, because ain't nobody giving us a shot. Ain't nobody knocking on our doors. Ain't nobody saying, hey, we got a deal. What the people around here have to realize is for there to be this much money, this much movement, this much people in and out of our area, this is where we should be standing up and saying, this is how West Texas looks, this is how West Texas sounds, and this is how West Texas is going to make its own spot in the game. You know what I'm saying? Everybody has their own little angle. Everybody has their own little niche. This is us, and this is us to the fullest. We're in the middle of the desert. Welcome to the desert.
We all got.
100.
Exactly. Yeah, man. So how's ODT been these days, man?
Man, ODT's good, man. You know, all my boys, we still, man, I got a lot of hard heads in the clique, man. You know what I'm saying? And I try my best to do what I can. But, you know, one thing about me and my ministry is I'm never going to force God on anybody.
Right.
It's one of those things. It's kind of like medicine. You're either going to take the medicine to make yourself better or you're not. So it's one of those things, man. You know, I do what I can whenever I can, holler at them when I can. You know what I'm saying? But just kind of one of those things as the kind of life that we live, man. I do a lot of work out there in the fields, man. I work about, you know, 70 to 80 hours a week. So I don't really have the opportunity to see them. And whoever's not locked up or whoever's not, you know, away out of state, then it is what it is. We kind of see each other when we can, man. But because of music, that's why it's really important that we keep it relevant. We keep it moving. Because of music, we always call each other, man. We talk, we chop it up. We talk about the good old days, man. Like, Breed, I want to give you an extra thank you, man, and an extra shout out, because one thing I got to give you, man, is a lot of respect and a lot of praise, because your consistency has kept this area relevant. I don't care what
Hell yeah, I can don't to that. I co-sign to that.
You know what I'm saying? I mean, there's a lot of people. There's a new age of artists that are coming up, man, and that's a wonderful thing, man. And I'm glad that I was one of the first cats in the area, but I'm not the only cat in the area. And so it's like,
let me tell you, Perk, when
we're all in the pool, baby.
Perk, when I first started rapping, you were the one. You know what I'm saying? Like, you were the hottest shit in Odessa. I was trying to, like, at least get your approval. When I was showing up at the shack back in them days, I was trying my hardest to sound as good as I can on each verse, because maybe y'all would like my shit. You know what I'm saying?
Look at it, man. Now you got people trying to come to you for stuff, man. Mm-hmm. And it's not about me. It's about the music. You feel me? It's about what it brings to the table. Now, like, a lot of people can take music and, again, can do, you know, whatever, you know, kind of be a little bit negative with it. Or you can inspire the next generation. You know what I'm saying?
Power so in the tongue.
Yeah. For a lot of people, you know, remember Perk from back in the days, but haven't been, you know, keeping up with him maybe for the past few years. You know, you're hearing a lot of positivity in his voice and a lot of things he's saying. What a lot of y'all don't might not have known, you know, is that Perk has gone heavily into the church, and you know, he's now heavily a man of God, God first on everything. Perk, you want to let people in on that and how life is with that?
Yeah, basically, man. I first, and y'all have to understand, like, I don't fake the funk at all. I like to go where people, where the church won't go, because when you look at what Jesus was doing, he was walking on earth. He was going where the church wasn't. He was out there with the killers and the thugs.
Right.
He was out there with the pimps and the hoes. You know what I'm saying? He was out there trying to win souls where the souls needed to be won. He wasn't in the church. He wasn't trying to act high and mighty, and we should emulate that, or at least do our best.
Right.
And my ministry, I'm trying to put the street back in street ministry. So when I go out and I talk to people, like one of my first road trips was actually a trip to Vegas, Sin City. Y'all be amazed at the gospel atmosphere and the Christian fellowshipping in Vegas. It's an awesome sight to see so much positive being, in constant movement, surrounded by so much negativity, so much, Vegas is real, bro. Don't get me wrong. I shot my first gospel video there, and I was ministering to people right there on the strip, and, you know, only God can give you a platform to be able to work in like that. But I got to give a lot of credit to my church. Shouts out to Goodwill Missionary Baptist Church in Midland, Texas, and my pastor, Kenneth Johnson, for just sitting me down and showing me that that I didn't have to always do what I was doing to be a full-fledged man. And I do feel like my testimony and the way that I used to live, shots out to the south side of Odessa, you know what I'm saying? Being shot at 18.
Shout out south side, baby.
I literally had a street pastor that was trying to talk to people on the streets of Clements, put his hand on my shoulder. I got shot in the drive-by. I heard a voice tell me that music is what I was going to be doing. I did not know at the time that that was God calling me. But it took from me being from 18 years old, being shot in that drive-by all the way until I was 32, I finally answered the call. So it's not like something that you just wake up one day and say, oh, I'm just going to start ministering to cats. I felt like I had to be ready. I had to have a story to tell and whatnot.
Yeah, you went through a big trial and tribulation to get to where you're at now.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Praise God. I made it. So, and I'm still, he's still working on me. I ain't perfect.
Yeah.
I still do things all the time, man. That's being a Christian or doing gospel rap, it's about being positive, but you're not perfect. You know what I'm saying? I just follow a perfect God. I'm an imperfect person. Every day I do something, it's going to be messed up. So it is what it is.
Right. All right, well, moving on. One more guest here for y'all. Surprise guest for y'all. You know what I'm saying? Here we
what
go.
What it do? What it do?
21st century.
What it do, what it do? We out here in West Texas representing your boy Rashid, a.k.a. Sheedy Gonzalez, in the building. What's going down?
Yeah.
Rashid.
Hell yeah. So we heard you was sliding through, you know what I'm saying? You was running from Hobbs this way and shit. So.
Hobbs, New Mexico. Shouts out to the other H-Town, Hobbs, you know what I'm saying? They get money out there. 369 for gas, they getting money. That's all I can say. They're getting money, you know what I'm saying? So, you know, it's all good. But no, yeah, I was coming through from New Mexico, and you know what I'm saying? Your boy hit me up, told me y'all had the radio show, told me about the other people that was going to be on the show, and you know what I'm saying? I heard everybody's name. I personally worked with Perk, you know what I'm saying?
You and Perk go way back.
Yeah, we go. So, you know, so here we go. We out here. I'm out here, you know what I'm saying? It's all love.
Hey, so what's the music scene like out there in New Mexico, you know?
New Mexico is cool. Well, I mean, you know, New Mexico is kind of like any other, you know, small town or small populated area. You know, it's a cult following. You know what I mean? In other words, there's always going to be something going on. If you go seeking, looking for something, then you're going to find it. And there's a lot of young artists coming up out of New Mexico. There's a lot of artists I've been on for back in the days out of New Mexico. But, you know, New Mexico range all the way from Albuquerque to Las Cruces to Farmington. So, you know, it's cool. You know, the scene is cool right now. It's all right.
Hell yeah. All right. So what's up with the camp, the home team? What's going on with 21st?
Oh, man. Well, you know, I got the 21st fam. That's all my youngsters. Then I got my Dope House fam. You know what I'm saying? Shouts out to all my 21st century fam coming up in the game zone. He been working real tough with J-Dog and Lucky Luciano, Steak and Shrimp. You know what I'm saying? Then I got Time. He just released a new CD. Y'all make sure y'all go check it out on iTunes. It's called It's About That Time. Paperboy G just dropped a new video in Mi Barrio featuring Lil Kane and Zone. So that's the whole 21st camp. You know what I'm saying? Then, you know, my Dope Dope House camp, man. Uh-huh. Everything is good. Bash, Low G, you know what I'm saying? Right. Unfortunately, Wine Gotti, you know what I'm saying? He not here right now. We on the free Wine Gotti campaign. He caught a little case. You know what I'm saying? I really can't speak on what the case was, but, you know, Wine Gotti gone right now. If you want to get with Wine Gotti, you can hit him up, you know, hit up his Facebook. His Facebook is still active, you know what I'm saying? But everybody good, you know, the Medicine Girl in California, you know what I'm saying? The SPM, he about to drop his new CD pretty soon.
Yeah, I saw Bash tweet something about he had actually spoke to SPM, and it'd been like years since he had actually heard his voice. Got me thinking, like, when's the last time you actually spoke to SPM?
Well, I'm gonna be real with you. My phone number just got denied because, and this is for the fans, this is for anybody listening. SPM has been moved from the All Red unit to Navasota unit, you know what I'm saying, which is closer to Houston, and he could use the phone now. So, you know, of course he can't call everybody, but they've been trying to get my number. So, personally, I ain't talked to him in a long time, just on the phone. It's been about some years since he called the Dope House. But, yeah, you know, I contacted him through letters, but hopefully, I think because of him, I'm going to have to switch from whack-ass cricket to Verizon. So, I can have,
You don't need to switch to wireless for you.
My bad. I forgot where I was. Shouts out to Wireless for you. You know what I'm saying? My bad. Verizon kissed my ass. You know what I mean? My bad. Man, that was sad. That remind me of a story, man. But anyway, but everything is good though. The camp is good, you know what I'm saying? So you wanna write the Mexican, whatever, you know what I'm saying? You can hit him up on spmaftermath.com. But you know, everything is good, man. The Dope House is good. But the 21st Century, them all my youngsters coming up in the game, and you know, check them out. You know what I'm saying?
That's what's up. All right, now that we got all these introductions out the way, let's move on to another part of the show here. Let's talk about the past weekend. What did anybody get into? Any shows, anything popping? I don't know. What'd you do this past weekend?
Man, I'm boring as fuck.
I mean, I shouldn't even ask you that, man. You at home taking care of your little one.
I got a 13-year-old. I get every other weekend. It was my weekend with my little girl. Oh, okay. So I just chilled at home.
That's what's up, man.
Writing a little bit.
Yeah.
Recorded a little bit over at Rob's house. You know, R1, shout out my boy, my producer.
Yeah.
Hell's Win. So, yeah.
How many people is he producing for right now?
Man, really?
Just
me?
Miss you? L.I. got anything? Even
man, me? Actually, L.I., the other day, I think it was yesterday, that fool R1 sent him a beat. So, he's fixing to get back on his grind.
Good.
You know, he's been chilling. Just sitting back doing his daddy thing.
Yeah.
Single daddy.
Single daddy
sons.
Ain't no joke, I bet, man.
So, yeah, so he's doing his thing. Shout out to all the single dads out there that ain't got to deal with deadbeat moms, you know. That's some bullshit. They always trying to give us a bad rap.
Yeah.
Later on child support money.
1 month.
Yeah.
Deadbeat. Mama give up all the rights. She just did, she just doing her life.
Yeah.
Fuck that.
So, Kashmir, what'd you do this past weekend?
Man, this past weekend, I put out a new single. Y'all probably heard it. I put it out yesterday, man. Break from Odessa.
Right.
Yeah. You know what I'm saying? Yeah, I made that cut out of Party Next Door, you know what I'm saying? That's a real fly group coming out from Toronto, man.
Yeah.
Shout out to Titan, though. Went over there, recorded that, and don't smash that shit, kill that.
Lying.
Yeah, man, shout out. Yeah,
where can they go hear that? I mean, what's
SoundCloud, man, SoundCloud. You hit me up on Facebook, which probably half of y'all already are.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? Phillip Mendoza, Facebook. Hit me up on that SoundCloud / Young Kashmir.
The day too.
Yeah, I mean, that's no below, though. That's no respect. No, I ain't shit without y'all, you know what I'm saying? I'm straight humble cap, down to earth, you know what I'm saying?
Yep.
Yeah. Feel that, man. It's no beloved. But yeah, this week was mad live, man. Shout out to my girl, too. Mad love making. Back in the jacuzzi. You feel what I'm saying? Fogging up the windows. Mad blunts, mad 40s in the south side of Odessa. You know what I'm saying? I mean, shit was real live this weekend, homie. But you know what I'm saying? We made some good music. Good motherfucking music. More music coming for y'all, too, man. I've been sleeping, you know what I'm saying? Lately, I've been on the grind, you know what I'm saying? I ain't been out here publicly posting statuses or nothing because I'll be trying to be in the lab straight. Working. I got mad shit, you know what I'm saying?
Posting pictures for the ladies and shit.
Man, you know what I'm saying? Every once in a while, we get some selfies in the motherfucker. But yeah, man, shout out to the ladies, though. Shout out to everybody listening, man.
Right.
Yeah.
Yeah, Perk, what'd you do this past weekend?
Man, this weekend, I actually just kind of chilled out, bro.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? It was my weekend to be off, so I didn't have to worry about them fields.
Yeah.
You know, working.
How many hours you putting in, man?
I'm putting in quite a bit, man. It's a consistent 70 to 80. Sometimes we get 90. The job that I had before that, I was doing at least 110 a week. And I'm just man, your boy's ready to just chill, man. So if these guys will, man, I'm gonna be looking for something different, man. You
know, need a vacation.
Yeah. It's gonna, I like to call it a paycation, but without, you know, the penitentiary. But man, we just kind of kicked it, man. I had the opportunity to do some things with my little girl. You know, it's tough, man. And shouts out to everybody out there every day that's out in the field so that people can drive their cars. Because it's hard to raise your kids over the phone. It's hard to my little girl's about to be 10 years old. She don't even know how to ride a bicycle because dad hasn't been there. You feel what I'm saying? Yep. It's hard, and you do what you can do. That's real. And sacrifice. Right now, you know, it's a sacrifice that I have to do. Yeah. And, you know, it's my season to gather right now. So, you know, until God says otherwise right now, I'm just going to gather up all my little o's and I, you know, put them all in a stack and then I'll go from there. Mm. So,
that's what's up. Sheep!
What it do? What it do?
I know you probably had the most interesting weekend and shit.
Nah, I ain't gonna say I had the most. I ain't gonna say that because I'd be honest. I'd rather be like y'all, just chilling. You know what I'm saying? Chilling that. You know what I'm saying? Chilling with my daughter. Chilling with the fam. But of course, my daughter graduates this Sunday. So
congratulations.
So, yeah, she's about to be 18. Yeah, so you know, I didn't graduate out of high school, but I mean, this last weekend, you know, just driving, man, just on the road. I drove from Houston to Dallas, then to Arkansas, then from Arkansas to New Mexico, then from New Mexico. I'm right here right now, so it's already the weekend, you know what I mean? So, you know, so that's basically, I mean, you know, it's kind of fun. I didn't bring my laptop with me. It's good when I could watch my movies. You know what I'm saying? I got my movies, so. Yeah.
You came in earlier and didn't have nothing to do and went to the movies, just mobbed by yourself and went up to the movies earlier.
To the movies and then went and seen the
Spider-Man.
Peter Parker? What is it?
The Amazing Spider-Man. Yeah.
We was talking about the comic book game earlier, you know what I'm saying? Because I used to read comic books. And what people don't know is it's three different types of Spider-Man, you know, comics that was out, you know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. So, you know, but yeah, I went and watched the movie, man, you know what I'm saying? Just chilled out for a minute. So, you know, but.
So you give it a thumbs up on that movie?
Well, yeah, I'm going to be real with y'all. This is my first time ever watching a movie in 3D. So, since it was my first time, I give it a thumbs up. I'm not really into the three, you know, I just try to, I stay up to with all the fads and everything that's going on, but I try not to fall into them.
You get hit.
But for my first time watching 3D, because you don't know if it's, I don't know if that 3D shit might be some kind of niggas in the trance or some shit. So they might hit a button later on down the line and everybody will watch a 3D movie start. So, my bad. But I give it a thumbs up because it was my first time watching 3D. So I give it a thumbs up.
Gives me a headache.
Okay.
don't do the 3D movies.
3D movies, hell no.
It got to be the right one for me to watch it, though.
Yeah. Well, it was my first time, so just I give it a thumbs up. I thought the storyline was cool. You know, I mean, I'm not going to lie. I'm used to the dude, Tobey Maguire. My bad. I don't mean to get too much into it, but, you know.
No, that's all we talk. He's okay. Talk about whatever we want.
But I'm a script writer, so, you know. So, I mean, you know, you talk about movies, I really get into it, but I'm not going to get too deep into it. Yeah. But I give it a thumbs up. Two thumbs up.
Hey, for those that don't know, Sheedy got a cameo in a zombie movie coming up.
That's a little independent film written by my homeboy Lil Young from Swisher House. Shouts out to the Swisher House. Shouts out to Lil Young. But yeah, Lil Young and his homeboy Manic wrote the film. And, you know, we hang around a lot, do a lot of work together. So I did a little quick little cameo in there. But for some strange reason, the cameo is the highlight of the trailer. So people hit me up like, nigga, I seen you in the movie. You know what I'm saying? But it's professionally filmed, though.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Like, it's not, you know, so... You know, but so shouts out to Lil Young, Swisher House.
That's what's up, man. Hell yeah.
One house to the next.
What up, Spree? Hey, shit, I'm gonna switch it up on you. Instead of asking you what happened last weekend, what's going down this weekend? You the DJ, what's going down this weekend?
Man, this weekend, you know, we turning up at Bob's, man. We do it every weekend, man.
Yeah, ho.
Shit. Y'all be sure to come out. Y'all be sure to come out here. Turn up, man.
We can't do that, man. We got a Chris brother now, man. We can't handle that, man.
But man, y'all come out there, Bob's, man. Every fucking weekend, I'm putting it down, man, you know? So, shit, come out there and turn up with your boy, man.
Yeah, shout out Bob's Billers, man. Y'all holding it down, man, putting that hip-hop out there. Ain't no other club out here doing that. No, shout out to, you know, DDP, you know what I mean, for holding that down, too, you know what I mean? No hearts for no other for artists and shit. You know, he straight put it on for us.
Speaking of clubs, anybody want to, you know what I'm saying, get at me on the show, book me for a show, just hit up my boy Breed, you know what I'm saying, hit up Half Breed, Versus, Hooks, whatever, you know what I'm saying. I'm out here. I might be gone by the time you hear this, but I might not be. I might still be out here, you know what I'm saying. So, you know.
Regardless, if y'all need something from Sheedy, you know, hit me up.
Yeah, get with Breed. But any of the hottest clubs, hottest spots, I got the new single, Porn Star, popping, you know what I'm saying. And
I'm not saying I need to get that, man.
Or the Porn Star.
Oh, yeah, I'm gonna need to get that shit, man.
Yeah, I've been pushing the song for a while, and what a lot of artists don't understand is sometimes it might take you a year to push a song. Sometimes some of the most popular songs, you know. So I've been pushing it for a while, but you know, so check it out. It's already on iTunes, but you know, that Porn Star, you know what I'm saying? You know, shouts out to all the beautiful women out there. Like respect. My man said. Respect, you know what I'm saying? It's all respect. But the song is actually it's not really an X-rated like type song, but I'm really saying she should have been a porn star. So the song is really about a classy woman.
Women at work, but
I'm visioning like, damn, she should have been.
She would have been a porn star.
And the song is pretty much clean. So shout out
to them classy women. Only be porn stars for their husband or whatever. Like, hey, look, they be married. You know what I'm saying? They be married. They be porn stars in the bedroom with their husband. You know what I'm saying? They only keep it like that with them, but in public. Yeah, classy as hell woman. You know what I'm saying? You would never imagine that. You know what I'm saying? You would never imagine that.
But I love you, baby.
Yeah, that's right.
There you go. Right, shout
out. Like you said, same sales, bro. Yeah. And I don't care if you in the religion from A to Z, you're gonna love your wife or women or whatever. So anyway, she should have been a porn star. Check it out on iTunes and motherfucking me. What's that? My bad.
She better been a porn star, baby. Bring that ass over here.
Yeah, check it out. Yeah, y'all forgot the.
Train derail.
All right. When you remember, get back to us.
Yes, sir. Oh, TuneCore.
There you go.
There you go. TuneCore. Yeah, I put the porn star on TuneCore because I went independent all the way on this one to see what I could do for myself.
Hell yeah.
I checked the numbers next week. I just released them. Check the numbers. So, anyway, moving on.
All right, moving on, we're going to go into something else here. We're going to talk about what new product everybody working with, what's coming out. I know you just dropped all that. But, up at Bob's, I've seen you perform a lot of new material. There's been a lot of stuff popping off for you here lately. What's going on? What you getting ready to do?
I don't know. I got hurt last year, so I've been kind of on the just grind all the time.
Just making tracks?
You know, yeah, I got hurt at work, so I ain't been working for the past year. You know, nothing but writing.
Yeah.
Writing and recording. I got a new shit. It's fixing. Hopefully.
That one you just posted... Let me just say that the wordplay on that was just off the Richter scale.
Amazing.
That was all right, man, salute on that.
But I heard that shit. I just
try to have fun with my music, man. There's a lot of times there's people like, I respect Cashmere, you know, he's a young cat, he's got wordplay.
Mm-hmm.
There's a lot of people, man, I respect their hustle, but I don't respect the type of music that they do because it's just all plain and simple, you know, it's all the same thing over and over and over.
Mm-hmm.
So I try to flip it up, you know, let them know what's up. Fixing to try to drop my CD by Hip Hop Fest, G.O.D.
Hell yeah.
Guns, Oil, and Drugs.
I got to cop one of those. I got to get one of those. Yeah, I got one of those.
Where'd you come up with the concept for that one?
Actually, it just came up in the track, man, because around our area is pretty much what runs the scene. You know what I'm saying? People always on that shit. Guns, you know, oil. Yeah. If you ain't working in the oil field, you ain't got no money.
There you go.
Mm-hmm. You know, if you ain't got no job, you running drugs.
There you go.
You know what I'm saying? You can't fight, you got guns.
Yeah.
So, I mean, it's pretty much that, you know, the government, the way they run things. You know,
yeah, that's worldwide. You speaking on it, that's everywhere. Guns, oil, and drugs, that's all around the world.
Not only here, but all in Afghanistan, homie.
We're so saturated with it in this area, man. It's like, they say, like, around here, they're price gouging on the houses and shit because they think everybody making that oil money.
You know what I'm saying? That's why that gas is so much in hives, man. You want to bring that back up on, right?
I just been working on that. Hell's Wind producing the whole shit.
That's R1, what's up.
Yeah, Amen, all the way up in Beantown.
Boston?
Yeah, Big Boston, man. Homeboy Amen up there, you know, he's doing a real
big. By the way, shouts out to John Cena. I did a track from when he... Niggas don't want to release it, man. Shouts out to John.
I remember that story.
No, I'm saying
that's 2-5, huh? That's 2-flare right there.
I got love for the boy. You know what I'm saying? Yeah. Shouts out to Cena. Shouts out to Bean.
Yeah. So I mean, you know, everybody's got their own little niche.
Mm-hmm.
I, a lot of people say my stuff sounds a lot more like, I wouldn't say backpacker, but it sounds, you know, it's got an East Coast sound because my producer, you know, he's he's more embedded in that type of music, you know. Yeah. We listen to a lot of Wu-Tang.
Yeah, but not a lot of cats out here coming with that. That's what sets you apart from everybody out here.
I love that shit.
I got a way different sound than a lot of people around here.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm not going to be braggadocious or nothing, but the people that try to do what I do, you know, they not nowhere as close. But
yeah,
I've been doing it for a minute trying to get... I'm not anywhere I need to be. Or actually, I'm not where I want to be, but I'm right where I need to be with what I'm doing. You know what I'm saying? I'm always getting better. I ain't perfect. But, you know, just reading, trying to get better with my words. You know,
oh, yeah.
Trying to get my diction straight. But, yeah, that's what's up, man. You know, that G.O.D.
Hopefully,
I got one more track to record for that.
And then yeah, everybody's going to cop that. Everybody's going to love that.
Yeah, they're going to love it.
Well, moving on here. Kashmir, what you got working on? What you about to drop?
Everything.
Shit, man, I got videos in line, man. I got two videos. I'm trying to push two videos off my last mixtape, No Kaluminati Volume 1.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I'm saying? I got two videos off. I'm trying to make two more. Then after that, I'm working on a whole new sound. You know what I mean? That whole mixtape, you know, shout out to everybody who got a tape from me. You know, I sold out. I got to get some more. You know what I mean? That's mad love. Mad motherfucking love. You know what I mean? Shout out to everybody who got copy tape from me.
Yeah, where'd you grab the name from? I was always curious, why'd you name it that?
Man, because everybody was always talking that Illuminati bullshit. You know, everybody was wrapped around this internet. Like, no, I had my little cousin. He was looking at a couple internet films, and he's all like, well, Illuminati's trying to get me. You got motherfuckers out here going crazy, you know, watching a couple YouTube flicks off Illuminati. Now they thinking a whole bunch of shit. Now they think Illuminati's everywhere. They think Illuminati's in the wall looking at you now. Yeah, like they watch. Yeah, you feel me? Like they're everywhere. They're on the phone and everywhere. But that's why I was like, kill all that bullshit. You know, Pac came out with it. You know what I mean? Salute to him. Everybody thought I was dick riding, but it wasn't none of that. You know what I'm saying? But on some real shit, it was just off something. Everybody was packed into that moment at that time. So I came out with that album. You know what I mean? But all them tracks were just recorded independently. Like I got my own studio, I had my own mic, you know what I'm saying, own program, everything but my goddamn self, because ain't nobody really wanted to fuck with me when I was recording that shit. You know what I mean? So shout out to everybody, any artists out there trying to come up with their own shit. Ain't nobody really fucking with you. Don't look for no respect. Nobody gonna give you none of that out here, homie. You gotta earn that own shit on your own self. You know what I'm saying? Ain't nobody wanna show me that. I was knocking on doors, motherfuckers would turn the lights off. You know what I'm saying? So what I do, I got my money right, got my own mic, got my own program, got my nuts together. When I started making my own songs, and I'm here right now. You know what I'm saying? 30,000 views on one video that I came off, and I don't know who the fuck I was. And I did that shit on my own. You feel me? So shout out to every artist out there. You know what I'm saying? Don't give no handouts from nobody. You get on your own. You know what I'm saying? That's how it is out here. So yeah, but I got mad music working out, man. So ready for a new sound, new mixtape.
Mm.
I ain't got no titles on it yet, man, but I'm working heavy on this shit. It's gonna be whole different new shit, new artists on it. It's gonna be dope, man.
Yeah, that's what's up. Perk, what you got going on? You got anything you working on? Any of the new gospel stuff?
Well, you know, I had my Only God Can Judge Me mixtape.
And right.
It's been out there doing.
You promoted the hell out of that when that dropped.
Yeah. I kind of have to, man, because a lot of people think whenever you go gospel, this cat couldn't survive with the rest of the meat eaters.
Yeah.
But that's not the case, man. I mean, I know a lot of gospel spitters, man, and they some real spitters.
Yeah, I've heard a few.
Gospel music is it takes a lot of the it takes I mean you can't lie about anything in gospel, you feel me, or else it's going to be tainted.
Exactly.
So what it does is it brings a lot of reality back to quote unquote reality music, you know what I'm saying, and it puts a lot of real back into real music.
Mm-hmm.
So that's why I like to promote my music to be real music for real people with real problems. But right now with that mixtape, you know, we're doing good on iTunes, man. I mean, I'm actually blessed to have an EP on iTunes and about 700 other companies that download my music. And so I just, man, that was an awesome little opportunity to be able to be on a platform where I could have that, you know, out there like that. But as far as like getting the record itself, you can download it right now for like $3 off of bigperkmusic.bandcamp.com. You know, I don't know if I'm supposed to say that right now, but I did anyways. But God forgive me for that. But
Perk was running internet before there was an internet. You know what I'm saying?
I had ODTRecords.com before MySpace, man. And there we had
sales.
Man, tens of thousands of
before
views.
There was even a thought of an iTunes,
man.
Perk was making mega money on internet sales.
Yeah. Definition of out the trunk.
Yes, sir.
ODT, ODT, baby. That's where it came from, baby. ODT out the truck.
From back in the day, man.
Shit, chatted on my motherfucking arm, baby. ODT for motherfucking life, baby.
Hey, man. Hey, I really appreciate y'all, man. Hey, you know, and we're still keeping that same idea. And like out here, that's why I said, you know, you have to pop trunk. These artists nowadays, what they got to see, what I hope that they get from this episode is that, you know, what I hope they get from this episode is that people like Rashid and myself, you know, we had to do a lot of things like one at a time, like person to person to person to person to person.
Hand to hand combat.
Yes, every time.
We're still hand to hand combat right now. Though.
Yeah, man.
Yeah. But you know what helps?
That's grinding, though. That's grinding. Grinding.
Internet outlets. You know what I'm saying? Having internet outlets does kind of help you. Yeah. And like Cashman was saying, when you have a video that's hot, you need to jump on that. When you have a song that's hot, you need to jump on that. Yeah. Because like Rashid was saying, you might have a track that's been out for 8 months, but they don't know about you in Seattle. They don't know about you in Japan.
Be
they
new
don't
to
know
them.
About you in Germany. Yeah, it's new to them. So the way I see it, if it's good music, man, you can market it forever. So with that being said, I'm still pushing Only God Can Judge Me the mixtape. Straight up mixed up by my DJ partner out of Chicago, DJ Smoke, and then I got it chopped and screwed by DJ Lil Mario out of San Angelo. So
shout out.
And also, what I got coming up is another mixtape called Crunk for Christ, and I actually have a 9-year-old rapper, and I have another 12-year-old spitter, and I have a 17-year-old spitter, and that one's going pretty well, man. And then I got a full-fledged album that I got called Swag, and that's Say With Amazing Grace, and I got artists all over the place on that one, man. I got 7 out of California on there. I got my boy D Hicks out of Seattle on there. I got my boy Adrian Butler out of Dallas on there, and I got a couple other cats here and there. But I mean, Sway from the Damage Crew out of Vegas. I got a lot of people been seeing this guy. His name is Brother Brian from Kingdom Music. He's all over.
I've been hearing a lot of Kingdom Music. That name's been sprouting off a lot.
Yeah, Brian, he's actually in Vegas right now shooting about 5 videos and doing some recording and stuff. And I got him on 2 tracks. And, you know, God is good. He opens up doors that men can't close. And if they do try to close them, he opens up a gate. So it is what it is right now. That's what we doing, man. Big Perk Music ain't stopping. And my shouts out to my management, Winnie Dorsey out of Maryland, and she's doing what she can do behind the scenes. And you know, it's about, like I said again, it's about music, getting it together, putting it out there, because people want music, man. Regardless of what they're going through in their life, that's a big escape for them. Sometimes you can have the worst day of your life. You pop in that certain CD, you push that play, and you gone. And so, as long as an artist, you stay true to that, man. It don't matter what kind of music you're doing, man. It's still gonna have some sort of place somewhere.
Yeah,
you know what I'm saying?
Already.
What it do, what it do. I'm just soaking up game, man. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, we should be soaking up game from you over here, man.
One thing I learned.
You on bigger status than us. You can never stop, man.
Well, one thing I learned in life is that, you know, that you can never stop, and you can always learn from anybody. Oh, you know what I'm saying?
Right. Yeah.
But, you know, just briefly on the new projects, because I really want to, you know what I'm saying, kind of, you know, cap on some of the stuff that everybody said. But far as the new projects, you know, I got the 21st Century Entertainment. That's my label. I got my new artist. I got Time coming out. His CD is already out. It's about time. I got Zone. You know what I'm saying? He's doing a lot of collabos with J-Dog right now. I got Willie P, producer, rapper. I got Tony Rex, producing the rapper. He just dropped the Green Fiend CD. That's my boy, Tony Rex, man. That's my
shout
boy.
Shout out,
right
shout out.
Yeah, shout out to Tony Rex, man. Y'all need beats, get a Tony Rex. Oh, but, man. I got Paperboy G also. He dropping some stuff. Kicks, my boy Kicks out in Illinois. You know what I'm saying? Like an hour out of Chicago. I think it's Springfield. I'm not really sure what city, but my boy Kicks, he dropping some stuff. Then I got my boy Lil Glock. Shouts out Big Cree, Free Big Cree. You know what I'm saying? He on lock right now out of San Antonio. You know what I'm saying? If I forgot anybody, my bad. But, you know, as far as my projects, I just dropped a CD called The Janitor. You know what I mean? And it's been going pretty good for me. Yeah, I appreciate it, bro.
Yeah, it goes hard.
I just, you know, it's independent. We independent out here. And the Porn Star was the first single off. Well, the first single off of it was called The Dope House Story. And that video is already up to like 100,000 views. You know what I'm saying? It's doing all right.
Killer.
You know what I'm saying? Yeah, it's pretty cool. Been out for a while, for a few months. But it's, you know, it's up to about 100,000 views.
Yeah.
And then I haven't done a video for Porn Star yet. I'm kind of just chilling, just bleeding the song a little bit.
Why haven't you done a video for Porn Star?
I'm telling you, well, man. Hey,
well,
yeah, man.
Well,
yeah.
Because I want to do it right. You know what I'm saying?
I would want to do it right, too.
Yeah, like I said, it's not really going to be. It's not really going to be like strip club, you know, in the video with the strip club with a girl half naked, you know what I'm saying? Like, yeah. It's going to be super classy. It's going to be like a movie, you know what I'm saying? Like office chicks and police chicks. But my bad. I'm thinking, you know what I'm saying? I'm like, we on TV and shit, but I got on my Ciroc Boy hat. Shouts out the time. We just shot a video called Ciroc Boy recently, so make sure y'all look out for that. But so I haven't shot the video for Porn Star yet, but yeah. I am, you know what I'm saying? I'm going to give it about another couple months. So I get the right type of budget for it. Because it's all about the budget. I'm going to be real with you. The budget got to be right. I can't come out with a corny-ass video to that joint. You know what I'm saying? So so that's The Janitor. That's already out. You can go download that on iTunes. That's all over. Shouts out to the www.sosouth.com. Then on the other note, I got the Cray Mofo project. You know what I'm saying? In line. It's in the line. Cray Mofo. For those that don't know what Cray Mofo is, that's just short for crazy motherfucker.
Tell him.
You know what I'm saying? So I came out. I got the Cray Mofo project. I got some good singles off of that. And then right now in the mix, I'm working on motion picture music, man, with Happy Perez, man. Shouts out to Happy P, man, for reaching out to me, extending love. Shouts out to Trey. Shouts out to Trey the Truth for reaching out to me, extending love, and dropping that single for me, man. Top notch for the new CD that I'm doing with Happy Perez. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah. Shout out.
Shouts out Trey, man. Hustle Gang, Hustle Town Gang, loves you everybody. But just, you know, real quick, that's the three things that I got on the lineup. The Janitor, Cray Mofo, and the Motion Picture Music Project produced by Happy P.
What's that Cray Mofo mean?
Crazy motherfucker. Short for crazy
motherfucker. Crazy motherfucker. You could have found a better name than that shit.
Yeah, that's what's up. All right, everybody. We're going to take us a quick commercial break. When we come back, we'll get right back into
it. You mean a commercial break or a smoke break?
Both.
That's a rocket. That's a rocket.
It's a banger though. Kurt ain't go where I play the rings. Shame zone, the fame zone. But I'm still good with that bottom bing, boy. Haka, my foreign chicks love coming to America. They go back like I never thought a problem would have me coming to America. Blast off, I smash off like broom. Broom with a bitch as easy as blues. Clues, dirty flow, need two brooms now. Diamond lane everything, we hitting everything like we was juicing. Minute Maid, knock it out the park. Another home run, then I run home. Cali mine, play with mine, make it run home. Why you on the phone line? By the nigga jump you. What the fuck you? No, it didn't never like that, but you saying that, so it kinda make a nigga want to. Me off the wheel, little bitch, I'm a bump in the fuck, then I pump, then I keep on the pump, then I dump, then I'm on to the next. Cop to the home with the chrome to your neck. Fuck all that, fuck all that. Why nigga tryna turn up one more time?
Tell me, let me know.
Y'all heard that joke why a woman's vagina is shaped up and down, right?
Let me know.
So when they go down the slide, it don't go. Right? You hear that shit?
Hey.
Yo, welcome back, y'all.
Right, shit getting crazy in this motherfucker, man.
All right, we're going to kick it off this segment of the show. We're going to start off with shows, man. I want to know about promotion, what's going down. Cashmere. Man. Saw you post something about Denver.
Yeah, man, we got Denver, July 19th. We looking out. Respect is due. Records, baby.
Yeah, you know, shout out. Respect is due.
Man, we making a movement. You know what I'm saying? Doing shows, regardless of where it's at. You know what I'm saying? From here to Fort Stockton. You know we're gonna be in Denver. You know what I'm saying? Denver, Houston. Mm-hmm. You know, from Houston, we probably got something in Vegas. You know what I mean? Just doing shows, man, and that's what it is. July 19th, Denver, Colorado, baby. We going to Yorktown, baby.
Colorado.
We blew the motherfucking roof off that bitch, baby.
Yeah, big shout out to Respect Is Due Records, everybody out there. The whole camp, you know what I'm saying? I fucks with all of y'all. Booster, holla at me. I want to get you on next episode. Holla at me, Booster. Holla at me. All right. Perk, you got anything going on? Is there anything? I know you always every weekend with the church, and you speak, and what do you got going on as far as shows or anything, benefits or anything?
Yeah, I got a couple of things that I'm going to be doing in June. I'm going to be over at Team Flow in Midland. I believe that's July the 10th. or it might be, excuse me, June the 11th. And I'm going to be talking to some kids about, you know, different things they got going on in their life and whatnot. And then I'll be ministering in Odessa, Juneteenth. Y'all know that's a big holiday for us. You know what I'm saying? It's one of the days where they kind of put aside for us African-Americans, a.k.a. black folk. And, you know, I'm going to be doing something at the park there. And then on the 20th, I'm going to be going with my boy Larry Campbell to Carlsbad. And I'm going to be doing a tent revival out there. Then I'm going to be going to Las Cruces, New Mexico for a little TV interview type deal on Saturday, the next day. Then that following Sunday, I'm going to be doing something with this cancer awareness group. And that's going to be kind of like a deal with a whole bunch of different Christian artists. People like Brian from Kingdom Music is supposed mm-hmm. to be there. And World's Rejects out of Houston. And, you know, a couple other cats here and there that's going to be there in Odessa. I believe that's going to be at the Far West Event Center. I'm not too sure on the venue right now, just to be honest with you, since I'm not really all the way in on all that. But, you know, it's just some things that I got going on right there. And then if you need any kind of information for the shows and updates, you can catch me on Facebook at facebook.com/odt.on.face.
ODT.
And you can also check me out on bigperkmusic.com.
That's what's up. How many shows do you have this weekend, which we should be asking you?
This weekend coming up?
Yeah.
About 100 million. Shit. Tell her, man.
I wish I could do it like that. But, I mean, I got a pretty little, you know, pretty busy schedule. You know what I'm saying? You know, I've been on the road for the last 2 weeks. I ain't going to lie to you, but I think I already explained that. Yeah, but I'm going to go back home and do a show in a small city called Victoria, Texas, which is like 2 hours outside of Houston. And then Saturday, I think the day is going to be open. But then Sunday, we got a big car show in the city that's called Pasadena, which is like a couple hours out. My bad. It's like 30 minutes outside of Houston. Somebody was saying, my boy Isaac was saying earlier about how you be in Greenspoint. It's like, nigga, we still in Houston. You talking about this Greenspoint. Yeah, you know what I'm saying? Because it's so big. But yeah, Pasadena is like going to the southeast side. And my homeboy Low Key throwing that show. So that's going to be on Sunday. I'm going to do that show, real show. I'm going to do my show early. I'm going to dip out. And I'm going to go watch my daughter graduate, man.
Ain't that
so?
That's nice, man. That's beautiful.
God willing, though.
That's more beautiful than any kind of show right there.
Man, bro. So that's all I want, you know what I'm saying, you know, as far as the weekend goes. But I mean, I know we're running out of time, but I just wanted to just say some things real quick, you know, just elaborating on everything that everybody was speaking on in particular, as far as doing a certain type of music and being a certain kind of way. And basically doing what you're doing, whatever you're doing, is always a market for it. It's always going to be somebody or something there to support it. You know,
like-minded individuals.
You know what I mean? Like, and I'm going to be real with you, you know, and I don't want to, you know, sound blasphemous or nothing, but, you know, gospel music is lucrative. You know what I'm saying? It's just like the trap music. You know what I mean? Yeah. You know, but if you're sticking with it and you're doing it, if that's your niche, it is what it is, bro. Yeah. And I believe in the balance of everything.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? I've been real, real poor. I never been rich, but I always been real, real poor. But I've been balanced before, though, to the point where, okay, I ain't broke, but you know what I mean? You know I ain't got to worry about it tomorrow, even though I ain't promised tomorrow. But then, you know, you never know what's going to happen when you, you know, it can happen to you, anybody. You drop a freestyle video or something, and next day, you know, you got $1 million in your bank account. Yep. You know what I mean? You know, so it's kind of like I believe in the balance. So when the money come in excess, if you can stay the same human being that you are, then, you know, you're straight. Some people lose it. Some dudes go do a lot of drugs, do a lot of coke, do a lot of liquor, do a lot of, you know what I'm saying, whatever. But I support everybody, everything everybody doing. I just believe in the balance. You know what I'm saying? You know what I'm saying? Christ, you know, that's my brother. Just like Perk, my brother. You know what I mean? Mm-hmm. You know. So it's all about a balance. You know what I mean? It's all about a balance. So that's all I want to say.
That's true. You know what I'm saying? Man. So, hey, Spree, what you got? Is it Bob's? Anything else? Any other gigs happening? Anything?
I got Bob's on Friday, of course, and I got 2 graduation parties, Saturday and Sunday.
Nice.
So turn up for the graduates. Congratulations to y'all, man.
Congratulations to all of y'all.
So
may your future be blessed. You know what I'm saying?
Man. Hey, can I kind of step in real quick? I just wanted to go down just real fast if I can. Rashid, do you remember that one time that I met, we kind of like bumped into each other at Trader's Village, and I happened to have like a full box of Dope House record CDs, and you was like so happy because you had just ran out of product, and everybody was like, I need some CDs, and we had
in Trader's in Dallas?
And Trader's Village, remember that? And I had a whole box full, and it was some of the good stuff too, some of that
SPM music still sells.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah.
Shout out to, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah. SPM, yeah.
I remember that, bro.
Man, that was just, it was just so funny how we just bumped into each other, and we were supposed to, you know, give that music back because we had one of our soldiers out there in the Dallas area that was pushing that Dope House music, and so we were just like, hey, why give it a Dope House when we can give it to a street vet?
That's love. That's love.
You know, and
just, I was just in Trader's Village too this last weekend.
Hey, shouts out to everybody that goes out there, like I said, instead of just sitting on the sofa saying that they're a rapper.
Yeah, I'm
just humbled to be in a room full of people that are actual artists that know that even though it may be a slow hustle, it's a for show hustle. That's what all the old people used to say. You know,
yeah,
what I'm
mean, and yeah, that's what they got to understand too. A lot of people want to rap. Everybody want to rap, but where your heart's at. You know what I'm saying? Like, I mean, everybody can pick up a microphone and do this and do that for a certain reason, but
don't do it for exposure.
Yeah, don't do exposure. Just because you're trying to get this old girl.
Don't do it for a popularity contest.
Nah, this ain't about none of that.
Don't do it for attention.
Nah, it's about your heart, your soul, and what your streets at, your creds at. You know what I'm saying? It's
art.
It's art, man.
It's art.
It's art.
Well, I tell you like this. When I first off, I ain't asked to be born. But the second thing is, I ain't asked to be a rapper.
Yeah.
It just happens.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
It's just in you.
Yeah.
I didn't go to college to be a lawyer or a doctor. Yeah, check the x-rays, nigga. Get that check that week. Nigga, I'm out here driving 1,500 miles.
I do that shit as a form of meditation. Just happen to be good at it. You know what I'm saying?
Exactly.
I've been doing it for a minute too. Spending in this town since 97. I'm still here. You know what
still
I'm saying?
Here,
I still do it just to do it. Because that's where my heart's at, man. That's what I love to do.
Respect. It's good therapy too. It's a way to relieve stress, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah, it's a hell of a therapy.
I know when I finish up a good song, I feel so much more. Yeah, I'm complete.
And it's a lot more legal than punching somebody in the face for therapy.
There you go.
Yeah.
I salute that. I
was stuck in that shit for a long time. That used to be my therapy.
That's right.
Yeah.
That's right.
Respect that.
Mm-hmm. Oh, for those that don't know, when we're talking about Ono here, you know, used to do Get in the Ring, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah. I'm a little cage fighter or something.
Oh, okay.
Summer, but,
hey, much respect, you know, for that, because
I got hurt last year.
That's beastly. That's a hardcore sport.
Combat, man. That's going to ring and get your job, bro. You better watch the fuck out, bro.
I've always said that Ono has...
Knock your head clean the fuck off.
Respect.
I've always said that Ono has a real warrior spirit. Like, for real.
I mean, that's the way I was raised, you know what I'm saying? It developed from, you know, having the type of childhood that I had, developed into using aggression in the street as a form of trying to relieve my pain by putting it on somebody else, and somebody catching me telling me, you know, you need to get your shit straight and come into the gym and train with us, or you're gonna end up, because I did a little stint for aggravated assault back in the day. People that don't know, people that do know, you know, they know what's up. And you know, my homeboy caught me, you know, I had my kid, and he was like, you know, I catch one more aggravated assault charge, I do some pen time. She was like, you need to come in, train with me, you know, do this shit right. So, you know, I did it for a while. You know, I hold one of the fastest knockout records in San Antonio for Premier Combat Group in 17 seconds.
Nice.
That's what it is.
See, that's what I just said about motherfuckers coming in and knock your motherfucking head clean the fuck off. You better be training for that shit, boy. You come in 17 seconds, you come in here training. Over here, travel, road trip, cousins, nephews, you're never 17 seconds.
You know, anybody could beat anybody up. You know,
if you ever got into a battle with Ono, ever, you're so fucking close to death and you didn't even realize it.
Bang.
You know, I wear it on my arm, man. Pain Bills Champions. And at one point in time, it was directed at what I was going for in the ring, you know what I'm saying? But the more I've looked at my arm every day, it's like, I'm a champion in life.
You have a real,
I'm alive.
You have a real competitive spirit, you know what I'm saying?
Anything.
From the ring to the battles, you know?
And I mean, that's, like I said, it just developed. I never asked to be born. I didn't ask to fight, and I didn't ask to rap. It just happened.
Yeah.
And speaking on shows.
Yeah, you know, did you, get back on subject here?
Yeah, man, I feel like I've oversaturated myself the past couple months, you know, up at Bob's, because that's really the only place that we got in this town.
Yeah, yeah.
There's not a lot of people popping off. You know, Cabanas, you know, they drop some shows, but they don't really fuck with my type of music a lot of times. You know what I'm saying?
Right, right.
And, you know, I'm not all for, you know, people ain't going to be feeling my shit. I'm not going to pay to do a show.
Nah, I'm beyond that. So, you know, like, I'm beyond paying for
really
a show.
Good. I'm really good. You know, I'm homeboys with DDP. You know, we're real close and shit. You know what I'm saying? Fuck you, DDP. But, you know,
be cool just like that. Yeah.
Fuck you, what you stand for. Love you, DDP.
Bang, bang.
But on the real, you know, I'm just going to hold back from performing for a minute. Finish this GOD CD.
Yeah.
You know, you're drop
gonna,
it on Hip Hop Fest.
You're going to make it to Hip Hop Fest?
Yeah, I'm going to make it to Hip Hop Fest, you know. Hopefully, I just got approved to go back to work, so I start next week, and the type of work that I do, I run casing in the oil field, so that's a 24-hour on-call.
Yeah.
I could be on the rig for 14 hours, I could be on the rig for 5 hours, you know,
right.
Just chilling, but, and then with my current legal status, you know, that kind of prevents me from traveling, you know, doing shows at bars, Bob's Billiards, shout out. I'm not there.
Turn it up.
You know, don't nobody tag me and Bob's, please. Okay. But
we on some real shit, on some street shit, right?
I don't even drive my car up there and shit. You know what I'm saying? But yeah, you know, I'm gonna hold back, and then, you know, I'm trying to get in touch with some people, trying to, you know, management and promotions and shit, trying to get my shit straightened.
Right. Well, hope you see you up there at the West Texas Hip Hop Fest, and I'm excited about that show. I like the way they bring all the elements together. You know, B-boys, DJ, you know,
graffiti
freestyle battles, the graffiti artists. Yeah, yeah. As a matter of fact, now that I'm sitting here, I just realized a connection here. The guy who's been doing all the graffiti at all the hip hop fests, Josh Jimenez.
My cousin.
And who else is?
Hell yeah.
Yeah, for those who didn't know, Kashmir and Ono got a little bit of relation there.
Yeah, somehow, some way. That's fucking crazy.
That's why we saw, that's why we be kidding.
And what, that's crazy. I've known Josh since junior high, like since I was a kid, basically.
Yeah.
Before I hit puberty, I've known Josh. Like
since he was 3'5". Still.
Bang, bang. I didn't say that. That wasn't me.
Man, that dude, he's been holding it down in this town for graffiti for
years.
A long
right.
time.
Years.
You know, anybody want to do some painting at the walls, y'all get at that boy, because
the walls.
Nothing go down
shout
unless
out
that
walls.
Boy approves yeah, it. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, matter of fact, you're on my YouTube channel right now. If you're hearing this, go look for the video 1000 featuring Carolyn Rodriguez. That's actually shot at the walls. You'll see some of Josh's work
salute,
right there.
Salute to that, man.
Actually, a lot of our older battles, they got some Josh doing some West Texas that's rap right. battle graph on, in the
right,
in the,
right.
in the beginning scene.
The old promo. I remember that. Yeah.
Straight
man,
down.
I missed that.
Hey,
that
I'm
old
be
promo.
Real with you. I pay attention to the battle league. You know what? Well, you know, I mean, I watch a lot of the East Coast guys, but I mean, well, it's not really just East Coast, but you know, I watch Grind Time. Well, Grind Time not really in no more, but I watch URL, King of the Dot. You know
yeah,
what I'm saying?
Fresh Coast used to be popular.
Yeah, Fresh Coast, yeah, it used to be popular. Yes, yeah, so I'm on that battle scene. I've been watching it a little bit. My bad.
Shout out to the hatred. for the people that could do that, man, and, you know, still maintain the same thought process, I respect it. But
hell yeah.
Right.
To me, I'm too much of a aggressive person to be. I can't let somebody just
sit there and insult you, man.
4'11" tell me that he's gonna sit there and slap me down or gun butt me. No, he ain't ever touched the trigger in his life. You know what I'm saying?
Bang bang, motherfucker.
I can't respect it, and you know that's where I lost it a lot.
Hell yeah,
yeah.
Shit.
Yeah.
But
you know,
young Sap.
You got battle rap, then you got freestyling. You know what I'm saying? Yeah. I'm gonna be real with you. I used to do a little battle rap, but when it comes to freestyling, that's more my forte. You know what I'm saying? You know, ciphering. Yeah. I guess you want to say
ciphering.
You know
that's cipher when everybody can vibe off everybody, man. That's nice.
Yeah.
When you're not saying, yeah. "Hey, yo, fuck you, fuck your mama, fuck everything that you stand for, DDP."
Bang bang!
I love you,
bang bang! Shots fired.
Battle tactics, man. Motherfucker holds it down for us in this town, though.
Hell yeah!
All right, well, let's move on subject matter here. Want to get into something? Let's just kick it off and go in reverse. Ono, what is your opinion on the state
of
hip hop in the 4-3-2?
Crisis. They have disgraced my family. Man, I don't know, bro.
Damn.
Like, there's some MCs in our town, they're dope, you know what I'm saying? Like I said, I'm not dogging on nobody, because everybody's got their own hustle, they're trying to do their thing, but
yeah,
like we were speaking on just a minute ago, you know, a lot of people do it to be cool, because they see Lil Wayne doing it, they see it on the TV, and they rap about a lot of the same shit you hear on the radio.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? To me, if you ain't out pushing pounds, if you ain't got a nice way, you still rolling a Corolla that you got from your mom in 92 that she had when it was brand new in 88.
Tell them.
You know, sitting on at the couch.
Preach.
You know, you're in the basement at your grandma's house in the closet. You know, that's your booth and shit. Everybody came from somewhere, but don't be talking about, you know, big mansion. There's the saying, fake it till you make it, and a lot of people do that, man. And it just saturates the airwaves and the youth's ears with a bunch of ignorance, man. And they think that that's what you need to talk about. That's what you need to have. That's what you need to see. When there's actually people, you know, I got a family.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? I don't speak on nothing that I don't think is real. You know what I'm saying? Yep. And if people were out there doing that shit, like, it just irritates me. I don't really listen to a lot of rap, man. Just based on the simple fact that there's too much of that saturation out there, you know.
Well, when you're not listening to rap, you know, what do you listen to?
Man, honestly, I listen to a lot of metal shit. Like, yeah, I listen to a lot of BLS.
Yeah.
You know,
I listen
to a lot of Tool, Deftones all the time.
Right.
Man. I represent Deftones big time. I love them. You know, that's some good baby-making music at the same time.
Shout out to the ladies.
Yeah, shout out to the ladies. But, yeah. Really, I try to keep it to where, you know, a lot of people like that, it's an art form to them.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? A lot of people don't respect the art form.
Exactly.
And they, like I said, they're just using it to be cool. You know what I'm saying? There's actual people that can flip their tongue. You know what I'm saying? Cashmere here.
Mm-hmm.
Never heard a lot of his shit. But then, like, once I watched him perform one night. So I started paying attention to his shit, and dude's got wordplay, you know what I'm
saying? Yeah, I appreciate that, man.
I never really, like, Perk been in the game in Odessa. I've been hearing his name for a long time, but I don't go out chasing to listen to people, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Because I, honestly, if I listen to a lot of shit, I don't want that to be subconsciously in the back of my mind, and then me end up saying some shit that they say, or wind up sounding like them. So I find myself listening to other genres of music, so I don't.
It's a hard habit when you're writing, too. Yeah, like, you listen to even, like, your favorite rappers, you know, when you write your shit, you kind of want to take a little something that they did. You know? Maybe, like, not the same words, but the way they said it, or something.
When I got out of jail,
you know?
At one point in time, like, Rashid, you know, my little brother was bumping a lot of his shit, and I listened to a lot of it, man.
Oh, yeah.
Appreciate it.
But, like, it's the Riddler on the roof, boy. I'll be bumping that in my cutlass all day, every day. What a motherfucking blood roach in my ass tray.
You know, shout try out, not baby. To saturate your brain with too much stuff, but, like, in Odessa, it's in a crisis, man. There's not enough people doing it for the right reasons. There's a lot of people doing it to be cool.
Well, what do you think can be fixed? What can it be fixed? How can we...
I think
get
motherfuckers need to start reading. They need to stop listening to the radio.
Your brain, man. Educate your mind.
Yeah, education, knowledge is power, man. And if, you know, get a dictionary if you need to get a dictionary. You know, read some poetry.
Yeah.
You know, just like get into, saturate yourself with the art, period.
Right.
And that's, I mean, if I do listen to a lot of hip-hop, I listen to a lot of, like, Kool G rap. You know what I'm saying? I listen to a lot of old school cats. Some new school cats that I like. Action Bronson.
Yeah, shout out to Kool G Rap.
Yeah, every time
Bronson.
It comes on that X, man, I'm checking
beast,
it out.
Beast mode. He sounds a lot like Ghostface, but dude's a beast.
Yep.
But yeah, Crisis. If you don't like what I say, do a diss track, bitch.
Bang, bang.
Disgrace my family.
That's fine.
Disgrace my family. Cashmere, what you feel like the scene looking?
Shit, man. All I gotta say, how the scene is in 432, you know, my city, my town, my, you know what I'm saying, my state. Any motherfucker out there ain't got no heart in it, and is just doing it for some pop off, or just doing it for some knockout, or trying to say something you ain't, niggas. Get the fuck out the motherfucking game.
Boom.
Check this out, you know what I'm saying? Over the years, it's gonna weed itself out. Them same fake, phony motherfuckers y'all thought was hot. No, 5 months from now, 6 months from now, they ain't gonna be nowhere to be found. Yep. You know what I'm saying? So I want y'all to see that and feel that. You know what I mean? It might be popping right now. Lil Nas or whatever. Not even popping, because in my thoughts right now, Bree, ain't nobody really popping out here, man. I mean, half of these cats out here is just so motherfucking phony.
No,
you know what I mean? Anybody
out
sure can't, though. Anybody, yeah, exactly. You know what I mean? So ain't nobody can say I'm number one rapper out of West Texas unless you got a fucking Grammy, $1 million house, and a Ferrari parked outside. You feel what I'm saying? Other than that, shut the fuck up, nigga. I mean, do your play and do what you got to do and stick to your hustle. Other than that, man, let the real cats do it. You feel me? Real cats in the studio who do this shit. But really, you know what I'm saying, live this shit. You know what I mean? Speak about some real lyrics on they on their music. Don't come out with no bullshit. Don't come out with no, I got 30 girls and you ain't even got a girlfriend. You ain't even got one girl. I see you at the club every day. You with five dudes. You ain't got one girl, but yeah, in your song, you rapping about you got girls and all this. You ain't even got a car.
I once had this.
Yeah, but you got a diamond bracelet. Get the fuck out of here. Just because you searched that.
Let me tell you a story. I once had this kid come in here and it was like his first time recording. And he came in and he had his shit all written and he got his beat and he came in and, you know, he laid down his shit and I'm listening to his words and he's talking about pimping caddies and all that shit, man, and Lambos and shit like this. And when he finished the verse, like I stopped him, told him, come out here. And I literally sat him down. I said, you just told me this is your first time rapping. You're a kid. Your mom just dropped you off.
Worst day of my life. Man,
you can't. I mean, you can't.
I said, I suggest you reevaluate what you're trying to do here if you want to make music.
I mean, I that's just real. I mean, you can't. You got to preach it to them. You know what I'm saying? They ain't going to figure it out.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Till later on when they really try to make it big and they do get big and they try to call them out and they pass and they found that old killer still live with his mother.
Yeah.
Oh, come on, man. You a bitch in the streets. Homie, I ain't never going to respect that. Where motherfuckers like us straight living in the South Side or straight living in the slums, straight spit it. Y'all better respect that shit. You know what I'm saying? Straight follow real shit. And we're going to keep bumping this shit. You know what I'm saying? Straight pumping this shit through West Texas, baby. You know what I'm saying? We got it on the motherfucking back. Shout out to Ono. Shout out to Half Breed, DJ Spree Park. You know what I'm saying? We've been doing this shit forever. You know what I'm saying?
Yes, sir.
You getting it, man.
Huh. Perk? What's keep good? It short, because you're going to go on with this one. I feel it.
You know, which, I've been saying this for a minute, man. And I just feel, as an area, man, the one thing, because, man, we got some spitters in this Dust Bowl. Yeah. You know what I'm saying? Yeah. We got some real spitters. It's not just the climate that's hot around here. We do got some actual cats that's got some bars. It's just, problem is, everybody gets to a certain level in the game. And I feel what Cashmere was saying, they get to where they feel themselves so much that they don't extend any kind of, I don't know if you want to call it like love for another artist. They just feel like they just the hardest thing out. Yeah. And I think that's backwards thinking. I want to take it way back, and Rashid might be able to co-sign for this. When DJ Screw was putting together, to me, one of the most influential rap groups of Texas, of the Texas type of music, if you listen to that kind of music or that kind of sound. When he made the Screwed Up Click, he had a lot of different artists from a lot of different labels. Obviously, that lets you know, and he was one of the most successful to do it. You might not have the best click in the world. You feel me? Like I have the Trump, you know, and my members are some spitters too. But I'm not going to sit here and say I have the elite under me. You feel me? Like, the elite comes from taking the best over here, taking the best over there, taking the best over here, and coming together and putting something together that's real. And what these cats are doing right now, man, they heavily saturating the game with what I say noise on beats. You know what I'm saying?
Ignorance.
And their ignorance, exactly. Ono said it first. Their ignorance is really making it hard for an artist to remain sought after. You feel me? We all have hot music. But the problem is, if we don't support each other, then who's going to support us? Because, see, what I'm tired of doing is, and I'm sure, Rosh, you will also co-sign for this, it's sad that you got to get into a car and drive 2 hours in any direction to find some love when we have plenty of people right here. Right. If my man drops a CD, what's wrong with me going and purchasing my man's CD instead of exchanging it for mine? Yeah. What's wrong with me going ahead and breaking bread, getting his album? He turns around, gets my album. I turn around to his homeboy because, you know, if he's an artist, he's going to have a homeboy with him that's an artist. And we all support each other. What I would like to see us do as a hip-hop community is the best way to stop hating is to really just start supporting each other. You know, I don't have to like you, but I'm going to respect you because it takes a certain type of individual, and real going to recognize real. I'm not talking about supporting the cats that's sitting there spitting fake. Yeah. I'm talking about cats that you know off the top that whatever they're spitting is coming from their soul. Music, regardless of what kind of music you're making, if you're not doing it from your soul, then it's like a void. Like you can hear it. Like I said, real recognize real. So my ears are already gonna start to be like, I know Cat, and I know he's not living life
effort
at this level.
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, exactly. So what I feel like, being in the West Texas area, we have right now is a time because we have been in the news, and I'm not talking just Odessa, I'm talking about Midland. Also, you know, shouts out to all my artists that are in Midland, Texas, because Midland has some spitters. That's why I say everybody that's in the West Texas area, there are so many different places in the entire country that's looking at our area because of the economic stability, because of the oil. Because like my boy said, man, all we got is guns, oil, and drugs. So what we need to do is, since that spotlight is in our area, it's time that we start showing everybody this is our look, this is our sound, this is our feel, and this is our music.
We all we got.
That's it.
Right. Yes, sir.
That's when you drop the mic and say you out.
Boom. Time.
Fatality.
Yeah.
See, I'm a co-sign on something Big Perk said. You know what I mean? Like, he was talking about DJ Screw, you know, coming together and bringing everybody together. Like, people in the Odessa area was looking at you like that. You know what I'm saying? We was looking at you like, you know what I'm saying? As DJ Screw. Like, that's how much respect you had in these streets. And you know what I'm saying? You mean you got a young messy like me, ODT on my hand, you know what I'm saying? Because I wanted to grow up to be like them. You feel what I'm saying? So, you know what I mean? That's a salute to everything you had, homie, but just... You know what I mean? I don't know what you went off to later off. You know what I mean? You went off in your...
Well, honestly, man, Cashmere, to kind of answer that, man, a lot of people always ask me what really happened with ODT. And it's not that anything happened with us. We all still there, and we all still got love for each other, man. And don't get me wrong, I got several artists right now. They fix and start getting back into it. But really what happened to us was the state of Texas, bro. It's really hard to be consistent. And like my man Ono was saying, it's hard to be in these bars and these clubs. And I, of course, I had all the legal paperwork to back me up, but it's just really hard because when you're a convicted felon, you're not supposed to be in the same room with another felon. Yeah. Everybody knows that. So everybody in my clique is a felon, and it's hard to just have to, man, and then cats bump heads, man, I'm trying to keep everybody unified, and I got the most rowdy bunch, you feel me? So it is what it is, man. I don't mean to take up a lot of time, but, man, we're still there, and we stopped because of the state of Texas, straight up, man. So, I'm not trying to put all the blame on the state of Texas, but it's just really weird when you got a couple of young cats trying to do something with their life, and then you put walls all around their life. And it's just really hard to just be in that life and not reach out and touch somebody on a real level.
So many walls, not enough ladders.
Yeah.
Rashid, since, you know what I'm saying, H-Town, you know what it's like. You know, you've been through the struggle. You've had more competition. Like, we have everybody out here, you know, we're all looking for attention, you know what I mean? But there's only a handful of us. You know, I could literally write a list and name every, you know, rapper that's worth a damn out here, you know what I mean? Over there, there's got to be hundreds of cats trying to come out.
Well, basically, from listening to your question, and of course, I can't speak on the Odessa market. I can only say good things about the city of Odessa and the artists in Odessa, because, you know, it's just out of respect. But the question is more universal. What is the state of hip-hop, period? And basically, bro, it's done expanded, bro. It's not niggas in the hood banging on the trash can no more, going off the lyrics, dope lyrics. Now it's whatever you can come up with creatively.
Yeah.
At that time,
yeah, people gonna catch on to it.
Because things are so much more easily accessible. Studios, now you can do them in your home.
Right.
You can do a studio on your phone.
But
man,
see, that's the yin and the yang of it. Because see, now that's where the artist, now that's where it's you ask about the state of, well, that too, but I'm saying you ask about the state of artists in Odessa. See, who's gonna step out of Odessa and go to Atlanta and go to New York and go to California and go to all of these different cities and represent Odessa? Who gonna do it?
Right.
Yeah. You understand what I'm saying? It's easy to sit here in the city. You know what I mean?
Right. And try to hold a crowd.
And that's not just for Odessa. That's even in Houston. And right. I got a motto, and I use this every time. I be like, "Yeah, boys, we talking. They ready to go on the road to do this." Soon as they see that state line and say leaving so and so county, no. I can't go back.
You're on your own now.
You know what I'm saying? I'm just saying, you know, it takes balls to get out there and go. You know what I mean? It's easy to stay here in your city and go to the club and do shows in your city. Yeah. You know what I'm saying? Like, I got to leave Houston every weekend. I don't have to. I easily go to any club and you say, "Hey, she, what's up? Get weed." Blah. You know what I'm saying? Make my little money on my verses. Nah, bro. I'm taking what we got and I'm taking it somewhere else. Uh-huh. But it's not easy. Right. You know what I'm saying? Right. It's not easy.
Hell no.
You know what I mean? I got here just because of a simple phone call. My boy Isaac called me and said, hey, man, come out. We're going to do the show. Boom. Because I'm on a wild-ass mission way in New Mexico doing something for some youngsters. It's survival, right. But at the same time, it take balls, man. Hell get yeah, on that yeah. freeway and ride down that freeway dealing with all these police and motherfuckers that, yeah, it's like you tell them you like Hives, nigga. Hives is, you know, and you right. I believe you. I'm out there, bro. In any city, no fear, but I ain't stupid, yeah, though. Right, you know what I'm saying? I'm not right, stupid. I'm not right, just gonna walk around in any hood like I'm a boss or nothing. Yeah, but for anybody that's doing it, with the respect of Odessa to Midland to New York to Cali to Texas, whatever you're doing, if you got the balls to take what you got and put it out there, that's what is really that's what matters, bro.
Hell yeah.
I done caught the Greyhound. I done walked. I done drove the bus. And I done drove my car.
That's
I done caught a plane.
That's real shit.
You know, so, you know, yeah. Whoever listening, it might be you, it might be whoever, but the state of the art is here. It's open game for anybody.
There you go.
But whoever going to go out there and go get it, that's what matters.
Because
we can sit in the city all day and be like, hey, man, fuck that, fuck that.
Yeah,
you know what I'm saying? See, Houston is a big city. It's the same problem in Houston. But see, this is different with Houston. It's 100 different rappers. But it's money out here, too. But the competition is deeper out there. Yeah. So you got a nigga with $1 million that can spend $1 million on a whack rapper.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? Yeah. But you got a nigga that can spit over there. He going cold. But... Mm-hmm. He ain't got the Jordans. Yeah. He don't got the bling. Mm-hmm. Or he don't, you know what I'm saying? Boom. But he's still working hard as long as he's doing what he's doing. But so the Houston market is different.
I could think of both right here in Odessa. Like what you just described, I could think of artists on both spectrums right here.
Yep.
Same situation.
Same situation.
So, you know, so basically, the game is open market for any and everybody. But it's all who gonna take the initiative and go out there and push that shit.
You hear that, P.O.? You need to get a little more lenient with them release papers.
Man, hold up.
Damn. All right, let's move on. Let's go to different stuff. This stuff we're going to do real quick right here.
Yeah.
This is the one we're going to call What's Good in the News. All I do is throw out a couple of news stories that I was seeing on Facebook from our local news supporters, if you want to call them that. But all I want is a quick soundbite from all y'all. What's y'all's initial reaction? Y'all don't got to go too deep into it or anything like that. All right, but this first one comes from NewsWest 9. It says... Carlsbad police tell NewsWest 9 a 42-year-old Carlsbad man was watering his yard when he was approached by two white males on bicycles. The two white males threw a flammable liquid at the man and lit a cigarette on him. The man was taken to Carlsbad Medical Center and later transported to an area hospital for treatment.
Stay strapped.
All I got to say is hot in the streets. Hot in the streets, man.
Stay strapped. Man, we keep... Hey, that's why I got my motherfucker pissing on me right now. You let some white folks pull up on bicycles. I'm blasting it. I don't give a damn. They ain't got to come 5 foot next to me. That shit already look creepy. You see two white folks? Hey, how old are they? We're like 30. They in their 30s or 20s?
I'm
guessing, man. They got to be in their 30s or 20s. Stay away from middle-aged men on bicycles. Point blank.
Yeah, middle-aged men on bicycles with lollipops, too. You got to stay away from them motherfuckers. Oh,
well, I say... Basically, if you believe in karma, then you never know what the dude did.
Yeah,
but at the end of the day, that's fucked up.
That's fucked up, man.
It's hot real in the streets,
that's
man.
Fucking, that's fucking evil.
You never know what dude did in his past, though.
I mean,
you know what I'm saying? You never know what he did in his past.
That's one of the worst deaths ever.
He didn't burn to death.
To burn though, period. I mean, your body, you got to stop dropping roll, motherfucker.
And that's what I look at when I got hurt at work, man. I could have died, but, you know, I jumped out of the way in time. But I look back.
You're a good dude, man.
I've done a lot of bad shit in my time, man. Just like I'm pretty sure each one of us have, you know what I'm saying? Being in this area and the situations that we've been in.
Yeah, Odessa is rough.
Karma does roll back around, man.
Hell yeah, it does. Yeah. I'm a firm believer in karma.
Like, you never know. Tell him what he did. Something. Yeah.
Tell him what he did. So, you know, but I'm not being judges.
He probably got a scared niece or something somewhere.
Who set the other motherfucker on fire? And then, like,
right, for all we know, they could have been on a bad trip and they just pulled up to the wrong address and Cat was sitting outside.
That's that ice. You know that's that saying? Ice around here. Man. Right, I didn't lay off that shit.
Well, let's move on. Next one comes from also NewsWest 9.
I had to pray for them.
I don't know if y'all heard about it. I mean, living in Odessa, y'all have been to Arbor Point at least one point or another.
Yeah.
But said a grease fire is to blame for the flames at an Odessa apartment building early Sunday morning.
Now check this out.
Let me finish this. The fire happened around 5 a.m. at the Arbor Point apartments. We're told someone was making chicken nuggets when the fire started.
Man, why'd it have to be fried
Southside Odessa, baby. That's Southside Odessa, baby. Southside Odessa, baby. Hey, baby. That's all I got to say today, baby. All
right. So shout out. They said in all, 8 apartments were damaged and 7 families were displaced.
Check this out.
Do not leave your kids home alone.
That touches me close to home because I got a relative that lives in a building that's not too far from that one.
Uh-huh.
And they got woke up at 5 o'clock in the morning and got evacuated from that building just due to smoke. You know what I'm saying?
Man.
So all I gotta say to that is they could have just went to Whataburger, man. You come home drunk in the middle of the night. Don't be throwing on a Fry Daddy. Bro. Don't throw the Fry Daddy on, faded as fuck, and try to cook you some chicken nuggets, man.
Pass out and shit, just barely half cooked.
Fry Daddy.
All I gotta say on that, man, is that man, you just gotta be a little bit more careful late nights, man. There's no way that at 5 in the morning, if they was going to work, like, I know my days start real early and end real late.
Shout out.
You got to have a little bit more awareness of your surroundings for that, man. But, sometimes, you know.
I don't think nobody was cooking no
chicken. I don't think so either. And I think maybe it might be something deeper than that.
I got the club. I got the story misunderstood. See, when you said chicken nuggets, I'm thinking he was cooking up some dope in the microwave.
I'm trying to
I'm reading right from the website.
Hey,
we getting out of the apartments for real. In one way or another, we leaving these apartments tonight.
Oh, man. God.
Them boys had an everything must go sale. It's hot.
It's hot in the streets, man.
It's hot in these streets.
We on fire.
Speaking of fire, all right, we're going to do our last story right here. The first two are about fire. This one's from CBS7. It's the title's a High Temperature Scorched the Permian Basin. This was on Monday. They got in Pecos, it got close to 110. What do y'all feel like the way this summer's going to be with this heat?
My city's death.
I shouldn't have been freestyling that day. That's all I'm saying.
My city dropping, baby. Illuminati Volume 2, baby. This summer is mine. I got videos coming out. Singles coming out. I got this whole motherfucker above it, baby. It's getting hot than the motherfucker.
Hey, yeah.
Hey, I want all my ladies to grab them thongs, though. Grab all them bathing suits and meet
this
me at my
West
crib,
Texas,
though.
Though, man. For real, though. You ain't used to that heat, and that's something new to you. You know what I'm
yeah,
saying?
Yeah, true that. True that.
Yeah, if you ain't from
born
here,
and raised,
different.
I mean,
y'all,
you know what I'm saying?
Like, you from H-Town and shit, you know, y'all got
humidity. They got that humidity.
That's the thing. See, I live in Houston. I'm originally from Philly, and so I look at everything on a global scale.
Yeah.
Y'all, you know what I'm saying? Like, y'all, you know what I'm saying? West Texas is cool, I understand. And it's a big political debate going on right now about global warming. Is it fake or is it false? Me personally, I feel like this motherfucker is burning up.
Hell yeah.
You know what I'm saying? That's just my question. You know what I'm saying?
It's a circle of life.
Just, check this out.
Get hot
when I get home from work, dog, I don't know what it is, but it's like it's a drain. It's a drain. My body feels the heat, and I don't think it's a coincidence. It's not a coincidence.
We all feel
that.
Yeah.
I don't know if y'all knew this, but y'all can get some information about people. You know what I'm saying? There's a lot of information out there about them manipulating the weather, and if you don't believe it, look it up.
I've heard of HARP. I've heard of the programs and stuff like that, you know, but, you know, you just don't know. You know what I mean? And I know the government is involved in, I mean, science is science. Yeah. And I know those motherfuckers experimenting every day on different shit.
Day.
You just heard a boom over there. You're like, God damn. Hey, who was that? Oh, it was just a little nuclear explosion. They just dropped 3 aliens off or some shit over there. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah,
you know? But I'm just saying, you just never know, bro. You know what I mean?
Yeah,
but I believe that the earth is getting warmer. I don't know where we headed to, but... you know, that's a serious subject, you know what I'm saying? But, you know, everybody just want to live
our
life and be happy.
Our summers consist of a good 100, 216 weather ever since I've been, you know,
hot,
living,
man,
living in this area.
It's getting worse every year, though, man.
You know how it is.
I work out Oilfield, you know, Park. I know you feel it, you know what I'm saying? Being on them rigs and shit, there's no sunblock. You know, there's nothing. And we got to wear them FRCs.
FRCs, yep.
That's long sleeve clothing, you know what I'm saying? You can't be wearing short sleeves. You can't have your shirt untucked.
I want to create an invention to keep your body cool. I was just telling my homeboy that in high.
Yeah, they got that. They got some kind of like suit or something like that.
I'm going to come up with my own. I can't do nothing. I can't make no money all day.
Money. Get it.
You know what I'm saying? We got the team right here to come up with our own.
That shit cool clothing.
$1 million. Split it 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 ways. Bang.
There's
seven
of us in
here. My bad.
Let's move on.
Seven. My bad, Spree.
Hey.
Y'all forget Spree's already locked away in the booth.
Yeah, man.
It's got to be like a free fall. You got to jump in there.
Yeah, there you go. All
right, let's move on here. I'm going to do a top three favorite rappers. Maybe not favorite rappers, but top three rappers that inspired you.
Hell yeah.
Man.
Good question.
You would go there.
You know,
I'm going to say Kool G Rap, Kumo D, and Method Man.
Nice.
You know, that's 80s.
Yeah.
You know, early 90s, mid 90s. You know what I'm saying? That's when I was really, you know, a lot of people are going to go to the Tupacs and the Biggies, but like, I'm a little older than a lot of the young cats. You know what I'm saying? I'm not looking at nobody else in this room, you know. This, you know, there's some young people and there's some old people, you know what I'm saying? There's people, you know, a lot of people nowadays would be like, man, Lil Wayne been in the game for a long time, that he influenced me. Yeah. You know, back in the day, you know, he was popping back in the day with Cash Money and all that. But, you know, my age, I grew up with that Kool Moe Dee shit, that LL Cool J's, Kool G Rap, you know, Big L.
Yeah.
Big L's.
Big L. Shout out Big L. That's a major influence.
One of my favorite CDs. Yeah.
Big Picture. Cassidy. The Big Philadelphia, picture. Man. Word.
Yeah, he had a big future.
But yeah, that's pretty much, you know, me. I grew up on a lot of Wu-Tang and shit. I didn't really get to listen to rap growing up. A lot of times my parents were against all that. You know, because N.W.A. is popping off. You know, they want me sagging and being a gangbanger and shit. But, you know. It's what it is.
What's up? Cashmere.
Shit, man. I probably have to go, you know what I mean, probably to, you know, every other answer, but, you know, Biggie. I grew up in that 96, that golden era, you know what I'm saying, that Death Row. Mm-hmm. You feel what I'm saying? Yeah. That Bad Boy, you know what I mean? All that, man. But, Pac, Biggie, that's a tough one, man. You know, you got Big L, you got Nas, man. You got Jada Kiss, man. You got a lot of heavy spitters that I listen to, man. You got a lot of heavy spitters I listen to. I'm more New York, you know what I'm saying? But,
yeah.
You know what I mean? At third, I had to give it SPM. You know what I'm saying? Just because he's Mexican, that's just like me. You know what I'm saying? That is just like, you know what I mean?
Yeah, he showed up. The Latinos, man.
Yeah, I mean, coming out of Texas and being Mexican, you don't know no Mexican rapper put it on like SPM. You name one, I'm waiting. You feel what I'm saying? Like, ain't no Mexican rapper put it on like SPM. So, Pac, Biggie,
this is for the last
Pac, Biggie, and SPM, you know what I'm saying? Wiggy, 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 Wiggy. Does your bitch got a name tattooed on the titty? Wiggy, 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 Wiggy. Hey, I'm in the Cutlass right now, bumping that motherfucking away home, boy.
Respect,
shout out,
respect,
man.
Respect.
That's my three.
Perk?
For me, man, I got to say my boy Scarface has been, man, so... It just seemed like every time he just captivated me with his stories, man.
Yeah.
You know, he was a big influence for me, man. And my boy K Reno out of the SPC. Matter of fact, I have him on my upcoming album. But anyways, he really inspired me on a lot of things.
Shout out K Reno, that's my homie right there.
Yeah, already, beast. Man. It's just the things that he raps about, man. It helps you gain a deeper spectrum of everything, man. You just kind of see everything in a panoramic whenever you listen to that boy. And you know, even though Pac was, like, to me, one of the persons that when he spit, he put you in the same room, he made you feel what he was spitting.
Hell yeah.
His flow was very simple, man, but that's just another reason why I feel like when you're spitting music, if you put your heart into it, you're going to feel that. You don't need all the extra ad-libs, all the extra little sound effects and all of that. You don't need all this dog barking and all these, all in the background. You put your heart into it, man, and the rest of the people going to ride.
Cool.
No, for real.
Sheed.
Well, top three, I mean, it's really kind of hard to answer that question.
Who influenced you?
Well, I'm a top three influences, since, you know, I'm a little older, not looking at nobody, you know. I'm a little older, you know what I'm saying? Just, you know, some of these cats. Rakim,
Yeah. Man.
Public Enemy and KRS-One. Those is like my younger years. Now I can go on, like he said, he went to NWA and the Spice One, and you know what I'm saying? Like, I could go down the line, but if I had to just really say my top three as a youngster that made me just be like, oh my God, this is what I want to do. Yeah, and it had to be Rakim, Public Enemy, and KRS-One. KRS-One, when I first heard was Love's Gonna Get You on that? When I first heard Love's Gonna Get You, I was in Louisiana. Nigga, I start crying. I'm in junior high with the B plus grade, but that's go way back though. Yeah. So you know what I'm saying? It's a lot of younger cats out here right now. But I will, like, you know, I got a universal thought pattern. So I know people might scrutinize me for this. I don't know if that's the right word, but I respect from the whack to the dope shit because it gotta be a balance. Yeah. Because without a whack, you can't have a dope artist. Yeah, everybody can't be dope.
Hey, you heard it here first, man.
Everybody can't be dope. You know, so you know, but my top three, KRS-One, Public Enemy, and Rakim.
All right. This next part here is for the audience, you know what I'm saying? We got the question for y'all. Down in the comments section, I want to know which two artists locally do y'all want to see collab with each other? Don't you think it'd be dope with some of these people? You like this song, you like that song, but you know they ain't never came out with a track together. Let me know. You know what I'm saying? The fans matter. We want to know who to reach out to, who to work with, who to have a new experience with on the track. So go ahead and name two artists y'all want to collab or see a duet together, all right? So, about to move on to the end of the show here, fellas. Any last words, any last thoughts, anything y'all want to say? Ono?
Man, I want to give a shout out to my boy L.I., Last Individual.
So when that beat?
We're going to be fucking around here real soon. Most often rewound, fixing to start working on a project. Want to shout out Elevated State of Mind. You know, finna be fucking with Elevated them real hard. You know what I'm saying? We finna start working on some shit to, you know, get their shit out there. Fucking my boy R1. If it wasn't for him, man, I wouldn't be doing this. That dude holds me down big time. You know what I'm saying? My girl, my kids. That's
big
what's
up,
up.
Big
you know,
up.
That's my you know, that's my heart and my soul right there. Everything that I do for them.
Yeah.
I ain't trying to be big rapping. If it happens, it happens. I do it for me. You know what I'm saying? I love what I do. And that's it. You know what I'm saying? Oh no, in the motherfucking building. Hell oh no, knocked it. One and only.
Salute. Hey, something to touch on what you was talking about earlier. I have Breed who should collab and shit over here in the 432. I'm feeling like me and you need to get on some on a track.
I've
been trying to collab with you forever.
Like, let me get a beat
I'm
or
here.
Something. Let
y'all
me get
know
a beat
where
something.
I'm at. Y'all here.
Hey, let me get a beat or something. You know what I mean? We kill that in the video. It's going to be live.
Yeah.
You understand what I'm saying?
I don't even want to collab with Cashmere. I just want to be in a video with him. So
look
at me in your video. I'll be in that bitch. At least to get
Hey, we got to watch the cameras though, man. I mean, Ono don't drink, he don't smoke, he don't do none of that.
Nope.
None of that.
Nope.
Remember that.
Nope.
Hey, but final thoughts, man. I want to give a shout out to all respect this dude. You know what I'm saying? Yeah. Boost, I ain't nothing without you, man. Keep grinding, that's the motherfucker. That's the boss, the CEO, entertainment, all that. You know what I'm saying? Doing all that, you know what I mean? Shout out to everybody. Shout out to the haters. You know, I love you, baby. Keep hating on me. You know what I'm saying? Y'all stay riding this motherfucking dick. You know, shout out to the fans. You know what I mean? Shout out to the fans, everybody, all the ladies out there. I got mad videos coming out for y'all. You know what I'm saying? More music, more shit for y'all to hate on, more shit for y'all to love. You know what I mean? Shout out to 0432.
He ain't even took his shirt off yet.
Oh, man. Shit. I don't think they want to see that,
they
man.
Don't. I don't.
Oh.
Turn from a fan to a hater.
Oh, my
God. Right there. I remember when I was young and in shape. You know what I'm saying?
Hey, man. That's loud shit. That's my G, baby. Rolling hard in. Shout out to Ab Bree. Shout out DJ motherfucking Spray, man. Yeah. Shout out DDP. Y'all holding that shit down, man. Shout out to my mother. I love y'all. Ain't nothing without y'all, baby. We still breathing, so we got much more.
Yo, Big Perk.
Yeah, man. I just want to give a shout out to everybody that's holding it down for the area, man. Yeah. You know, my Out the Trunksters. What's up, y'all? I want to say what's up to all my the people that are really close to my heart, man. Of course, my beautiful wife. My kids, I wouldn't be here without y'all, because without them, I wouldn't have changed my life.
There you go.
I want to also give a shout out to, you know, my personal savior, Lord, Jesus Christ. And also, he's still working on me, man. So if y'all see me and I'm doing bad, just pray for me. You know what I'm talking about? I ain't nobody perfect. I'm just trying my best to do my best. You know what I'm saying? That's it.
Yeah.
And also, man, I just want to give a shout out to the people that continue, like I said, to provide platforms like this. Bree, there's no words that we could tell you that with enough appreciation that things like this need to happen more. If it wasn't for people like DJ Spree, if it wasn't for people like Isaac with Wireless For You, if it wasn't for people like Bob's Billiards, if it wasn't for people like DDP, Bree, the producers, the DJs, the artists, everybody coming together, the B-boys, the you know, Josh and everybody out there tagging and different people that bring their little elements to hip-hop for our area, we wouldn't be here. We would be just really on the air talking about nothing but the heat and the dust. You feel me? So it is what it is. Yeah. I appreciate everybody. Like I said, look me up on BigPerkMusic.com, and to God be the glory.
Already. Spree.
Yeah.
Say something.
Man, shout out to everybody in the West Texas, man. I'm turning it up for y'all, man. I do this shit for y'all. Shout out to all the artists doing everything out here, holding it down for West Texas, man. Yeah, ho, you know what it is, man. Come out to Bob's and see me, man. I'm
Bob's
putting on for y'all,
right across
man.
From OC on Andrews Highway. Yes, every Friday, open mic night.
As far as DJ goes, I think DJ Spree puts in the most work in this town, man.
Bro, I grind,
as a DJ, man. Especially like, as a DJ, man.
Yeah, but
I grind, man.
You know, Spree's my best friend and all, but I still have to give shout out to others out there. You know, Danny G.
Yeah,
you know what I'm saying?
Yeah. Turn up for all the DJs, man. They do it.
Anybody
man.
Doing that,
it
you know
right
what I'm saying?
Here,
like Park was saying, anybody that's putting work out here who's continuing this, you know what I mean, this movement we got, you know what I mean, whether it's new school, old school, whatever the fuck, you know what I mean? Keeping this shit pushing, you know, we all we got.
Yeah.
Just keep pushing and shout out to everybody, you know what I mean? In it for real, though.
Yeah, man.
And shout out to Spree.
Rashid.
Spree. Oh, it's all good, man. I'm, you know what I'm saying? I'm on foreign territory, man, enjoying my day. I mean, I got some bad news today, you know what I'm saying? Which, like I say, it's, I always look at things in a universal fashion. And I just got a call today that I lost a good friend. So I just want to tell everybody, appreciate your life. It might be bad. You know, situation might be tight. It might be hard on you. You know what I'm saying? You know what I'm saying? Stomach might be growling. The bill might be due. Whatever, whatever. But as long as you alive, it's always a brighter and a better day.
Amazing.
You know
hey, salute that, man.
And then
so, Yeah. Shouts out Ronnie Spencer, man. You know, so that's it, man. Really appreciate your life. That's all I want to say. You know, we done pretty much talked about everything else, from music to, you know, religion to everything. So I'm going to just end it on that note. Unless you're going you gonna be able to come up with that beat.
Yeah, we got about to get on that beat right now.
Turn
West
up.
Texas, are y'all ready? Here we go. Episode 2, Freestyle West Cypher.
West Texas, let's get it. Half breed, homie flipping it first. Off in that Infinity Radio, freestyle verse. I got my peers riding with me. People come get a sample, but don't let your mama hear this shit or you'll get slapped with a sandal. I'm talking about the damn chancla. My boy still smoking ganja. We in this bitch like every weekend. We don't speak no drama. So step your game up and maybe you'll be invited. And once you step back in the lab, I bet your ass get reminded. Hey yo.
Oh no. From OD to Beantown, hell's when the rewound, I'm trying to focus my chi now. I'm in the building straight, holding my team down. These motherfuckers know that we gon' clown. Every time that we split, bust your lip. Hit the ground, watch the fucking blood drip. It doesn't matter cause I'm better than them. And if you wanna talk shit, yo, I'm battling in. I fucking take it to the stage, take it to the cage. Get up in my face, you gon' see my rage. Off the top, you won't see no page. Cause these motherfuckers coming through, they in a daze. Off my haze, Daisy. Motherfucker, that's the way they made me. I'm just a bad motherfucker from the 80s. Slap these kids, treat them like some ladies. I got rabies foaming every time I spit. These motherfuckers trying to act like they a clique. But I can run up one man wrecking ball.
Yeah, I'm dropping dimes, matter of fact, I'm fucking dimes. Fuck around, yo ass get hung like clotheslines. I rap, I don't need no punchlines. Eat rappers all day like it's crunch time. Oh, I mean it's lunchtime, my time. Better yet, I better fucking shine like it's sun time. Out in the recess, boy, you get left. I get right all night with your bitch on my dick. And she just might suck it, homie, hope she don't bite. Don't bite me, no, she love me, but I got it wrong. Better yet, I got a backseat in my fucking car. Better yet, I got a backseat in my homie wall. Better yet, I nigga, she taking it all, taking it gone. I'm running in this game, homie, you know when I'm wrong. You know when I'm gone, you know when dead. Once I'm in my zone, ain't nobody fucking with me. You fucking with me, homie, get your ass back to the whole lap. Got your girl right here, right next to the lap. Got a whole map, better yet, I got a fucking blunt lid. Oh shit, bitch, I don't fucking tongue kiss. Hold all these hoes, nigga, you know how it go. Where the money get, show me where the dough's at. Better get, whack rapper, show 'em where the dough's at. Nigga, get that shit, I'm so gone off the Coney, yeah. Shout out to the homie DJ Spree, Bree, yo, Rashi, got me high, dog, got me moonwalking on clouds, dog, man, I'm whole load. Ain't nobody really stop me, I'm rocking Versace, nigga, but I'm lying. Better get, you test me and you die, the bullets get to fly. Your niggas laid out, your homies played out. How you really want it, I'm getting tall, it's splitting. Cash me in the building, homie, fuck around, no written.
Spree, I'm going in, man. Let's get it. Going in like a fireman. I don't give a fuck about it, don't give a damn. What you saying, though? I don't give a fuck about these haters, hoes. I don't give a shit about it, though. I got it unload. Ripping, dipping, then I'm out. I don't give a fuck. I'm a man, you a boy scout. Everything you talking about, that's nothing. I don't give a shit. I click you off like a button. Man, yeah. Cutting down the aisle. I don't give a fuck, that wood brain got a crab. Buckle up in the truck before you get stuck in your mouth. Yes, you know I rep the dirty south. Yeah, all the time, do it daily. Screaming out, fuck you, pay me for these haters. Fuck it, I'm riding like a damn skater. Tony Hawk with it, don't talk with it, I'm out, yeah.
Tony Hawk with it, niggas going bald. No, I'ma keep it real as these niggas take a fall. Got a star when it's falling on his heart, a stethoscope. Break it down, I keep it real, I got a fucking chest of dope. Keep it breaking off, then hopefully, nigga got the dope for me. Keep it real, shouts out to SPM that wrote to me. Coming with the coat, it's the riddle up on the roof. I break it down and hit these niggas, even if it got a bulletproof. Take it out to the bottom, my boys will look to the top. With a woman to drive, I do the rap shit, your boy never flop. Got that coming through the pop, I got the chopper in the cerebellum. You can get your posse, pussy nigga. Niggas better come and tell them, I make a swell up. Niggas get the hell up. I got the boys yelling. I travel like Magellan. I whoop a motherfucking nigga like Shalons did the Jay-Z. I break it down, I heard your flow. Your shit is kinda lazy. Niggas are crazy, oozing daisy when they pushing up. Keep it real, I'm coming through. My niggas bout to cushion up. Get a higher fire like the plane when it crash. Like the Malaysian air flights on the dash. I'm looking for your boy like Jay did the dash. When they coming through, I'm bout to come up in your stash. It's a robbery. Shake them like the ivory. I be goddamn. Damn, if I let a nigga clobber me. Gotta break it off, coming through with some motherfucking serving grill. Got the type of shit that's like Sarah Palin on a pill. That's the female governor, nigga never loving her. When I pull my pistol out and I be slugging her. Drag the bitch, a nigga living for the ragamuffin. Rude boy, come break it down, then I come and stuff him up with the bullets. A nigga about to feel it, it's the fullest. The ballad of the menace with the triple bullets. I got the hollows, niggas about to follow. Is that your bitch with the mouth full of dick that swallow, swallow, swallow?
Infinity Radio.